at least 5 to 10 engineering support and symposiums or other type of events in Macedonia, which means that from the monies which are they obtaining from the engineers for the subscription, they are supporting education and the next projects as well events in Macedonia. Here I have in this slide situation with the licenses within this chamber and the situation with the geodetic licenses. We have two types of licenses. There is license A and license B. License A is for bigger projects and license B is for smaller projects, which means, for example, if you want to make design any project or to implement any project for any small house, you need just license B. If you want to deal with, for example, roads and other big projects, there is a license A. And there are four type of licenses, which means designing, supervision, revision and construction. I made search yesterday for the number of licenses in Tetovo. And I got this result, that in Tetovo there are just two licensed geodetic engineers with licenses A for designing, for supervision and for construction, but there is nobody with any kind of license A or B for revision. And in the left part of this slide, it is in Macedonian language, there are the details for the geodetic department within this chamber.
Live.
Now, yes?
How do you explain that there's so few people with the licenses? Only two?
Yes, because when I mentioned before, for the trade companies, the geodetic companies, I mentioned that they are dealing mainly with cadastral works, and they are not so interested into the engineering process. In the other side, there is another also big problem, that all construction companies, they have employed the geodetic engineers with licenses, and that's why another geodetic engineers who are dealing with geodesy and are employed in private geodetic sector, in geodetic companies, they are not interested to have this kind of licenses, because of course they need to pay for each year for the chamber. That's why they don't have any job in with this kind of projects, and that's why they are not interested. But if we check in Skopje, the number is huge.
Yeah. For a place like Tetovo, which is here, I would say the developing.
Yes.
Would you say this number is too small?
Yes, of course. That's why I was surprised yesterday. Yes, I was surprised because I know that in the past period, at least 10 or 20 our colleagues, geodetic engineers, they had the licenses for engineering works. But now, I suppose they that lost their licenses because, you know, of the subscription and continuously maintenance of the...
I believe that the company that we're going to visit today, which is, maybe Professor knows, Geoplan.
Okay, yes.
He's, if I'm not wrong, he's one of the best companies here in Tetovo. As I know, and he's one of the biggest company in Tetovo. In this sector. I mean for Tetovo.
Yes.
Not for, as I said, Skopje, you can find very big companies. Yes. And I'm sure that the company that we're going to visit today has the license. Geoplan, Professor Jakub. Yes. Okay.
The problem is, as I said, because they are dealing mainly with cadastre.
Yes.
With parcels. with construction and
with the buildings, with houses. So this is the main point.
What is the professor? Sorry, what is the main issue? Why they are losing the license, for example?
If you don't pay,
the fee.
Yes, yeah. And you will lose that. And of course, you need to go into the educational workshops and seminars. If you don't go, for example, I have one a colleague from Struga. He lost his license for surveying works from the other channel, not from the engineering channel, but from the authorized surveyors. Why? Because in 3 years ago, he didn't went to three seminars, but he passed just two seminars, and not three. But in 5 years, he had 14 seminars passed, and just one, because he didn't went on 3 years ago, he lost his license, and now he has to go to exam from the beginning.
To get back the license?
Yes, yes.
How is the experiences in your country?
I have no idea.
Yeah.
I have no idea how this field works.
Yeah, no, because not just the geodesy, if I'm not wrong, professionals may be better. Only medicine, pharmacy, everything is this way.
No, we are organized.
They have to go to visit workshops, and you can lose only for one, and then you should go back. They're very strict in that aspect, but how much is the effect on that?
What I know is that
it's
very regulated.
Yes, but it was very stupid for me.
Yes.
Because that guy, he's working as professor in Nikonesta. And he had never used his authorization to sign any project or any document. And he lost his authorization just because he didn't want into one educational center. And what is the impact? I asked our agency, okay, what is the impact of one seminar?
Yes.
In this case, where he is not dealing with the business.
Yes, he's not.
With the private sector. He's yes. Teacher in secondary school, you know.
That's it, yes.
And, but this is the law regulation, and we can do nothing for it.
Yes, and we hope it will be changed, maybe.
Okay. It's just workshops. Yes,
but it is
rule.
Obliged by the law.
Yes, of course.
And we can not change that. Okay,
thanks.
After the government institutions and both chambers, which are related to the private sector, now I have some slides for the trends in Geodesy. Why? Because our secondary schools have to be aware for these trends and not to work just with the rules which are coming from government and from our channels. Now, I will list many, many things which are not related to our institutions, which you cannot see in our private sector. For example, you mentioned that you have been visiting the companies in Kotovo. And also, if you go in Skopje, in our companies, you will not see many of the trends which are now in Europe and in our developed countries. In first slide, I have four fields which are related to the geodesy. One is remote sensing. Remote sensing, which means using of the satellite images for performing of geodetic works. Here we have also the aerial photos, which means that we can take the information from a distance, not to go in a field, but we can use another technologies in order to get the data from the field. After that, we have the GNSS, which means Global Navigation Satellite System. There are four satellites which are currently in use. All of us we know as GPS because it was the first and famous one. But also there are another system of satellites which are integrated, for example, in our even in our CAN GPS devices. And also we have coordinates in our mobile phones, but all of these coordinates and the location is based on this kind of satellites which are which are in function to locate our device in the world, in space. Then another trend is aerial photo by drone, which means we can use drones for making aerial photos and also for making the digital models. Even we need digital terrain models, digital elevation models, or digital surface models. Also we have GIS. The GIS is that geographical information system, and all data in one system in order to have the databases for geospatial information. Another trends are scanning, 3D scanning by using professional scanners to make 3D models. Then we have SDI, NSDI, GSDI, also there are the local SDI, regional SDI. SDI means the spatial data infrastructure. This is one of the biggest opportunities of geodetic engineers nowadays, because today we are not talking just for the data, but how can we get the data? How can we reach the data? Via internet. For example, if we need any information for this building, for the municipality, for any tree, even any tree in a field, how, with which infrastructure, with our technology, electronic technology, we can go to this tree and to get all information. That's why we have SDI, spatial data infrastructure. There is NSDI, national spatial data infrastructure, which means all data of the country into one portal. And GSDI, this is